bow break, let it come down, crash. Let the sun fade out to a dark sky. Can't say I'd even notice it was absent. 'Cause I could live by the light in your eyes. Unfold before you what I've strung together. The very first words of a lifelong love letter. Tell the world that we finally got it all right. I choose you. Oh, I will become yours and you will become mine. I choose.
When I see Mimi and Henry together, I see what one can call a power couple.
You know, like how these fingers fit into each other and it's right. That's what I think of Henry and Mimi.
The best of Mimi compliments Henry. The best of Henry compliments Mimi. And it's just beautiful to see.
I see love. I see a difference in expression, which is nice. I felt like Mimi was such a soft, humble person. And because I know Henry, I know how irritated he could get, or I know how he could be so real, and sometimes the things that he says is so harsh. So I see a balance of two different people.
Henry and Mimi make a perfect team because somehow they have matching energy.
Jim,
we're coming, guys.
Jim, like there's a war.
It's like they're from the going to be the join the special forces. Jim is all the time.
Jim. Yeah. Swimming. What?
And the same energy they have for themselves, loving themselves and being together. Thank you.
I first met Mimi and Henry when they came over to my house for my daughter's birthday. And for a long time, me and Henry had been searching for that girl who would, you know, conquer his heart. So when I saw him with Mimi, I finally knew that Henry had got the missing rib. He looked so relaxed around her. He was blushing around her. And for once, I told Henry, I think finally, we've met that person we've been searching for. I need a girl like you,
girls like you, the funny man. Henry's named after King Henry VIII of Agincourt in England, and he has actually surprisingly lived up to the name. He is strong, he is one fit dude, he's smart, he is cunning, he is very enterprising, and he's always looking for ways to outsmart everyone else, so everyone around him should be very mindful of that.
Three things that come to my mind. Henry loves cooking. He loves his food. Miriam, beware. Henry's a workout freak. He loves going to the gym. But above all, he's a very hardworking and focused guy.
We grew up together. I used to bully him. I used to pick on him. I would send small, big Ronnie to beat him up for no reason because I saw him as my competition for the love of the family. I just couldn't believe there's this young kid who is younger than me in the family. I was always used to being younger.
If I was to describe him, would be kind-hearted, polite, funny, and all-round just someone quite easy to talk to, and definitely someone valued within the family.
I would describe Henry as a very reliable and strong individual. I've found him over the years to have earned those stripes. Henry started just like any of us did.
He's caring, pays attention to details. I know that's someone I can always get, you know, the real raw advice from.
Hi. I'm Patrick, aka Fernando, Henry's other brother, Henry aka Alejandro. This is family, my wife Anne,
hi.
My sisters,
hi.
We say hello.
He's funny, he's loving, he cares about us. Henry buys us wine. We love you so much. At the lockdown
moment,
we spend our evenings with him, mostly playing board games, Ludo, cards. And he was always cheating, but it's okay. You won those games? You won those games, hope you're proud of yourself. And we are so happy for you today. We are so happy you gave us our sister in love, Mimi. We are so happy this day came to pass and we wish you all best.
Yeah. Henry, so smart, so neat, so hardworking, so caring. I tell Henry I have a problem and he will be their number one before my other brothers.
He's neat. Like everything is smart. It makes everyone of us feel like we are the most unserious people. We love you, Henry.
Me and Henry call each other psycho.
Yeah.
You're psycho, my psycho. Oh my God, I'm
psycho,
so excited. Baby. I'm so happy for you guys. Henry is very, he's a planner, I think.
Oh yes.
So much. He looks the part. So organized. And then he encourages you to actually really take care of yourself. Like, love yourself so much.
True.
So, I'm so happy for you guys. Oh, have the best rest of your lives together.
Yay!
Mimi is so many things.
In one word, I would say Mimi is colorful.
And me being the youngest one, I've always looked up to her with everything. I'm at school, I'll call Mimi. I'm having an issue at home, Mimi is the one I run to. And she just always has answers like that.
She's creative, funny, interesting. She's very smart, intelligent. Well, at least she's smarter than me.
She's like just a problem solver, an answer giver. It doesn't matter what time in the day, it doesn't matter if she's just woken up. That's just who she is.
She's book smart, she's people smart. I don't know, sports smart too. She's a good swimmer.
For the time I've known Miriam, she has been a very, very kind girl. Miriam has always had that open vulnerability that, you know, attracted me to her the first time I met her. She's a very strong girl, very loyal, very fun-loving, with a very, very great voice. We actually bonded over music and songs and stories and all that. That's, we share so much in common. I've known Miriam to be a very, very God-fearing girl. Miriam, in all her friendships, she's always the sweet one, the one who's thoughtful, the one who remembers. She has never missed any milestone in my life. And of course, when she chose to cross River Nile twice to come and attend my, you know, intro as a bridesmaid, I knew that I meant so much to her and she does to me.
Well, what I know from the few times I've met Miriam, she's a quiet person. But when you engage with her in conversations, that's when you realize that she's a bit stubborn. But she's interesting to interact with, yeah.
She knows what she wants and she goes for it. And she doesn't come second. It's either first or she doesn't take part.
Henry loves daring sports. Oh my goodness.
He almost killed
skydiving
twice when you're still back.
Bungee jumping. Oh, water rafting.
He almost left us there.
Henry loves the adrenaline rush. He's just.
But we have. He wants to kill us after time.
But we know he does it all out of love. Because he loves being with us, loves us. He loves it when we are happy.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But Henry fears death. Henry fears dying. Oh my God. Alejandro, I have no child yet. I'm not dying now.
Yeah, that's it.
So, this is something I hope Miriam get not to pay attention to. Was one day when I think Miriam was about 12 years old, we were walking down this road and we kind of disagreed. So I walked ahead of her and she was walking behind me. And she didn't want to catch up with me, and I hope she did not catch up with me. But then lo and behold, just as we pass a home, a dog jumps at Miriam, barking wildly and heading for her aggressively. I turn back and I see her run towards me faster than she had ever run before. I was afraid of the dog, but I stood my ground and wished this dog got closer so that I could deal with it. But thank God, the dog backed off. So Miriam, please, when you need any assistance, don't hesitate to run faster than you ran last time.
The one time I remember, we were, I think, driving to go to Lera, and we had an accident. And without Henry being there, it would have been very difficult because, you know, he was very sort of calm and eased everything, you know, sorted the situation out. So I think that's one of the things I remember.
Me and Henry would hang out with Barbara.
No, I haven't met
him. And each time we hanged out, he had a paper of the things that were pending for him to do. So every year, one of the things that was always pending is getting a wife. So I'm glad that finally we can no longer tick off that as pending, because Henry has finally found himself a wife.
Of course, from school, when Mimi was a head girl at Nalia, we used to misusing powers and everything. She was head girl and I was a dormitory mother, of course, with Sandy. We used to kind of stay behind in the dormitory and just, you know, sing, not for anything, not you, but just to write songs together, to imagine ourselves as those Barbie princesses. I used to call her Barbie because she's the one who used to sing like Barbie and all that. And yeah, sometimes we'd chop prep under the guise of supervising, but we're not really supervising. Yeah, I've never really done things that are so naughty, but that's one of the fondest memories I have.
He's more focused now than ever before. I think he now looks toward settling down, you know, being a family person. But above all, Henry actually loves God. So I think Mimi has also impacted on him because he tells me that Mimi loves the Lord. So I see him moving in the right direction with Mimi by his side.
He really pushes her to be or do more. That is the biggest impact that I can say. Because Mimi is very hardworking, but she also knows how to chill. And sometimes the chilling can be a bit like too much, but Henry will be there and just tell her, Mimi, we have to get this thing done, and they'll get that thing done. That one I've seen him do very well. He pushes her and also encourages her to live. Those are the two favorite things that he has done for her.
Miriam has been really focused, but now I think her focus has exponentially multiplied, because now she sees things that in Africa they say what an elder sees while seated, a young man cannot see even if he climbs the tallest tree. And so Henry coming into Miriam's life, I think Miriam now sees even better than the elders.
He has helped her build confidence. She's a confident woman. I've seen her move from that girl that was, you know, openly vulnerable and who used to not, like, should not really stand firm for herself. I've seen her change. She has grown. She knows what she wants. I've seen her, you know, more confident than before. So I think that is Henry's doing, because she can be herself around him and, you know, he backs her up in her decisions she makes. So, yeah. And every time she talks about him, Henry did this and he did that. So clearly he has a very, very good impact on her.
The fact that this event is happening is already a big milestone. I mean, we know lots of people who, although they feel something about the next person, but they don't manage to take the big step. Henry has, Mimi has, you guys both have.
I think she has made him a lot more sociable, a lot more communicative. She's made him more responsible,
women do that. And he's more accountable now. That's what I'm beginning to see. He returns calls. In the past, he'd be too busy to return calls. We still have that issue. So Mimi, thank you for that.
Mimi, you've got yourself a very nice, jolly, focused, hardworking guy. Take care of him as my brother. I wish you all the best. And Henry, please take care of Mimi. Good luck and God bless you all.
Miriam and Henry, congratulations upon this milestone. Congratulations upon this marriage. And I pray that the Lord continues to bless you.
Henry, you've gotten such a gem. I know you love her. And my prayer is that you continue to love her regardless, forsaking all, just like your vows say today. You know, in Mimi, you've got a treasure. And you know, this is a gift that God has given you, in addition to your marriage, of course. And the woman is the glow of what the man does. You know how people like saying behind every successful man there is a woman, but actually behind every strong woman there is a man who loves and appreciates and, you know, gives her the confidence to thrive and all that. So you've done so well so far. Yeah, my prayer is that you continue to do that and much more as you two grow together, that you give her that fairy tale life she has always loved. Yeah, the Disney kind.
To Henry and Mimi, I am grateful to God that you crossed paths. And just know wherever you are, you have our love. And we look up to you guys. We hope you guys' love will be like this. So we have something to hope for. We're waiting for the grandkids and we'll be telling, you know, some silly stories later on in life. But we wish you all the best. I wish you love and happiness.
Henry, you're taking away my sister. I've taken the whole year to process and make peace with it. I'm her favorite person in the world. Now she's going to have you and juniors. And instead of competing, I'm going to be mature about it. You have a gem. Love her, be patient with her. And just keep doing you, because she's with you now because of who you are and who you've shown her you are. So just continue with what you're doing. Where she says she's a good communicator, she actually taught me how to communicate, so I don't think you can have any issues with that when it comes to her. You just have to hear her out and make her feel like, yeah, I can talk to him. Otherwise, you have the best woman in this world.
Miriam and Henry, we bear witness, and we have always borne witness to the love that you have. And my prayer for the two of you is that you be the example that we'll look up to, the rest of the world will look up to. So be strong, be encouraged, and know that what the Lord has brought together is destined to stay together. And he who finds a wife finds a good thing. So Henry, my friend, you have found a good thing.
Enjoy each other. Please enjoy each other as much as you can. Don't let the small things bigger than they are. And take care of each other and make as much memories as you can. Live life to the fullest.
Mimi, I would probably say enjoy the moments, you know, enjoy the little moments that you have together. Enjoy the love that, you know, you guys have created with each other. And yeah, just live it to the fullest. That's what I would say.
Welcome Mimi.
I love you so much.
Yeah.
Can't wait to spend weekends with you.
Any day, anytime.
Yeah.
We can't wait to visit.
We love you.
Visit, we'll be part of the house.
We are part of the house.
Make for us house kick-off.
Part of the honeymoon. Part of the honeymoon.
No. I hope your house has rooms.
Yes.
And we don't mind crashing in the living room.
Thank you.
Henry, you know, as you embark on this journey of marriage, I'm praying for it to be long-lasting and filled with the blessing from God. You know, I'm sure you know, this experience, this new chapter in your life will be something, you know, you'll value. You know, I always think about when sort of I want to get married and I look up to my older cousins, and you know, to see you taking that step and going off to build your own family is truly something, you know, remarkable. And I wish you and Mimi all the best of luck in the future. And yeah, I'm looking forward to you know, the wedding and seeing you guys on the day.
A message to Mimi. Mimi, you are welcome. We haven't met yet, but I already feel that we have. And in some ways of understanding, some people could say that we have. And I want to say that you are welcome in the family. And I hope that you will enjoy your relationship with Henry, and that you will also grow together with Henry.
You're a lucky girl. Good catch. Hold on to him real tight.
I know you're going to have a wonderful marriage because you're meant for each other. You're friends. You are lovers. You are compatible. And you're good for my brother. So I'm happy.
Congrats, guys!
Congratulations and congratulations and Kongs and Kongs again once more.
Yeah. May this be a new journey full of blessings. Love,
peace, joy, calmness.
Nice everything. Looking children, many strong babies. Children, babies. Many babies, twins, triplets. Why? Let them fill up Uganda.
Oh. Vilma has a bouncing castle. Yeah.
Yeah. It should be filled up.
If there's a question of my love, you got it. Baby, don't worry, I got plans for you. Baby, I've been making plans. Oh, baby, baby, I've been making plans.